Hello everyone, this is Professor Pawan Shankar and I welcome you in a 45th lecture of Machine Design and Drawing 2. And this is a last lecture of our syllabus. We have completed around 4 units. Okay, and specially I am conducting this lecture to cover unsolved numericals on a last unit and bearing part. Okay, so let us try to solve as maximum as problem in this part. Okay, so numerical number 6, let me tell you, these are the numericals on bearing. Okay, so we are practicing and this is unsolved numerical from Khurmi. A numerical is 80 mm long journal bearing supports a load of 2800 newton on a 50 mm diameter shaft. The bearing has a radial clearance of 0.05 mm. The viscosity of the oil is 0.021 kg per meter second at the operating temperature. If the bearing is capable of dissipating 80 joule per second, determine maximum speed. So operating temperature is not given here. Okay, so let us collect the data. So here length is 80 mm and load is 2800, diameter is, either you can write small d, 50 mm. This is the diameter of journal actually, so let us write small d because capital D is used for diameter of bearing. Bearing has a radial clearance of 0.05, so radial clearance is given as a C1, which is C by 2. Okay, so C1 is 0.05 mm. The viscosity is given, Z is equal to 0.021 kg per meter second. And the last part, if the bearing is capable of dissipating 80 joule per second, so heat dissipated is given as 80 joule per second. So determine maximum safe speed. N is to be calculated here. We need to find out RPM. So let us start with a formula for C1. C1 is what? Radial clearance, and radial clearance C1 is given as C by 2, where C is diametral clearance. Okay, so hence C equal to C1 into 2. So C is 0.05 into 2, that is 0.1 mm. Okay, now here heat dissipated is given, so considering heat generated and heat dissipated is the same. Okay, so assuming there is no loss and heat generated is equal to heat dissipated. Okay, yeah, this is very ideal condition. It is not possible in a practical situation, but for sake of numerical, we are considering heat generated is heat dissipated. Hence, Qg equal to Qd. Okay, so Qg is equal to Qd is equal to 80 joule per second. That is given part. Now, bearing pressure. Bearing pressure. What is the pressure? Pressure is load upon area. So it is load upon area, and area will be A. So W is given as 2800 divided by area will be projected length of projected area of bearing, that is length into diameter. So L into D. So 2800 by 80 into diameter is 50. So we'll get here pressure, and its value is 0.7 newton per mm square. Very simple formula it has, that is pressure is load upon area, and specifically bearing pressure for bearing area is projected area of bearing, so length into diameter. So this is what the bearing pressure. Now we'll go for the equation of coefficient of friction. So कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ फ्रिक्शन म्यू. सो म्यू हैज इक्वेशन 33 बाय 10 रेस टू 8 जेड एन बाय पी एज यू नो डी बाय सी प्लस के एंड वैल्यू ऑफ के इज 0.002. ओके इफ एल बाय डी इज अ रेशियो बिटवीन 1 to 2. ओके सो k has a value of 0.002. so continuing equation of mu equal to 33 by 10 raised to 8, then z is 0.021, n is unknown, pressure is just calculated as 0.7 newton per mm square, then d is a 50, then c is 0.1 plus k is 0.002. Okay, almost done here. So mu will be in the form of n. Okay, because all the values are known here, only n is unknown. So what are the value we'll calculate here? That is 4.95 into 10 raised to minus 6 into capital N. This is RPM, this is not the Newton. Okay, plus 0.002. Okay, because this whole part cannot be calculated without knowing the value of capital N. Okay, so we have calculated here mu in the form of N. We'll use this equation later on. Now, velocity is given as V is equal to pi dN by 60. So putting values, pi d is 50, but we'll calculate velocity in meter per second. So 0.05, got it, into n by 60. Okay, so velocity will be again in the form of RPM. So 2.61 into 10 raised to minus 3 into n meter per second. I specially written here unit just to avoid the confusion that this n is representing what? RPM, not a Newton. Now heat generated, we have a equation of heat generated, so hence heat generated Qg equal to equation is mu into W into V. So let us put all the values. Qg is 80 equal to mu is 4.95 into 10 raised to minus 6 into n, plus 0.002. okay, this is our mu. Into W is 2800 into V is 2.61 into 10 raised to minus 3 into n. So as you can see, in whole equation only RPM is unknown, so RPM n is 1298.74 RPM. Got it? So this is a solution. Got it? Clear? Let us go for next numerical. Next one is 100 mm long, 60 mm diameter, a journal bearing supports a load of 2500 newton at 600 rpm. If the room temperature is 20 degrees Celsius, what should be the viscosity of oil to limit bearing surface temperature to 60 degrees Celsius? So if here viscosity is to be found out. Diameter clearance is 0.06 mm and the energy dissipation coefficient based on the projected area of bearing is 210 watt per meter square degree Celsius. This is not per, this is only degree Celsius. Okay, so let us collect the data. Here length is 100 mm, then diameter is 60 mm. Okay, sorry, length is 100 mm, diameter is 60 mm, then load is 2500 newton, 600 rpm, that is capital N is 600 rpm. Room temperature, that is TA, is given 20 degree Celsius. Z is to be calculated here, and bearing surface temperature, that is a TO, operating temperature, is given 60 degree Celsius. Diameter clearance is 0.06, that is C equal to 0.06 mm. Then capital C is 210, this is small c, okay, 210 watt per meter square degree Celsius, not Kelvin, because temperatures of surrounding and operating are given in degree Celsius. Okay, so these are the given data. Let us start with the heat dissipation. Okay, now heat dissipated, given as, heat dissipated is given as QD equal to what equation we have, C into A into TP minus TA. Actually it can be written as TO minus TA by 2. Is a bearing surface temperature, okay, so it can be TB, it can be considered as a TB. So QD equal to C is 210 and A is 100, that is area, length into diameter, 100 into 60. Now see here, we have used here C, heat dissipation coefficient is 210 watt per meter square degree Celsius. So meter square, that is we used in the meter. Here our diameter and length are used in mm, so I am converting these mm into meter. So 100 mm, so 10 raised to minus 3, and again mm, so 10 raised to minus 3, so it becomes 10 raised to minus 6. Now TB, that is 60, okay, bearing surface temperature, and TA is 20. So we'll get here QD, heat dissipated, as 50.4 watt. Now next is velocity. V is equal to what equation we have, pi dN by 60. So put up the values, pi, D is what, 60, so 60 into 10 raised to minus 3 into N is RPM, that is 600 by 60. So we got velocity as 1.88 meter per second. Okay, now bearing pressure, small p, is given as load upon area, area is L into T. So load is 2500 by, length is 100, diameter is 60, load upon area. So we got pressure as 0.416 newton per mm square. I request all of you to please go through this calculation actually on a Calci. Okay, don't rely on my answer. Now after bearing pressure, we'll calculate coefficient of friction, that is mu, is 33 by 10 raised to 8 z n by p d by c plus k. So 33 by 10 raised to 8, z is unknown, okay, n is 600 rpm, pressure we have calculated 0.416, then D is 60, C is 0.06, plus K is as usual 0.02. okay, so we'll get here mu in terms of Z, so that calculation is 0.475 into Z plus 0.002. Okay, so now we'll use equation of heat generated, and considering heat generated is equal to heat dissipated, so QD equal to QG equal to equation is mu into W into V. So heat we have calculated, heat dissipated as 50.4 only. 50.4 in equal to mu is what? 0.475 Z plus 0.002. This is a mu. W is 2500 and velocity is 1.88. So here only Z is unknown. Easily Z will be calculated. So Z आना चाहिए 0.0183 and unit for viscosity is kg per meter second. So this is the solution. Very simple numerical these are. Okay. Now the last numerical that we'll cover over journal bearing. This is the last numerical of last unit and this is the last lecture. Okay. Thank you for your kind support. So let us complete it. Data. A journal bearing is proposed for a steam engine. The load on a journal is 3 kN. So load is given as 3 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. Then diameter 50 mm. Next part is length, so L is 75 mm. Speed, that is capital N, is 1600 rpm. I know that I am covering this numerical very fast, but we have already covered this part, covered this portion, and we have already solved this numerical or like same numericals, so that's why I'm doing it fastly, so that we can cover at least three numericals in this lecture. So speed is 1600 rpm. Diameter clearance, that is a C, is 0.001 mm. Then ambient temperature TA is 15.5 degrees Celsius. Then oil SAE 10 is used, and the film temperature is 60 degrees Celsius. So TB can be. TO can be 60 degrees Celsius. Determine the heat generated and heat dissipated, QG and QD to be determined, and viscosity, that is Z, is 0.014 kg per meter second. So now solution. First of all, we'll start with the bearing pressure. So small p is load upon area. Load upon area is what? Length into diameter. So load is 3 into 10 raised to 3 divided by length is 75, diameter is 50. So ultimately bearing pressure will be 0.8 Newton per mm square. As simple as that. Okay, so bearing pressure has been calculated. Now the velocity, V is pi d n by 60. Putting values, pi, diameter is 50, so 50 into 10 raised to minus 3, because velocity is to be calculated in meter per second. RPM is 1600 divided by 60. So velocity should come out like 4.18 meter per second. Now the next part is obviously coefficient of friction. So mu equal to, what is equation? 33 by 10 raised to 8 Zn by P. I hope you got this equation now. Zn by P D by C plus K. Put the values 33 by 10 raised to 8. Z is 0.014 into N is also given 1600 by pressure is calculated as 0.8. So it becomes Zn by P. Then D by C. So D is 50. C is 0.001 plus K is taken as 0.002. Okay. So your mu should be 0.464. So we have calculated here mu. Okay, three basic equations we have used for bearing pressure, velocity and coefficient of friction. Now, the next part is what? Heat generated or the heat dissipated. So, heat generated. Heat generated, that is QG is equal to, what is the equation? Mu into W into V. Do we have all these values? So QG equal to value of mu is 0.464 into W value is 3 into 10 raised to 3, that is 3000, and velocity is 4.18. So QG equal to, it should be 5818.56. No, unit should be watt. Okay, and heat dissipated. For heat dissipated, actually that equation is a C into A into TB minus TA. Okay, so instead of TB minus TA, we can use half of TO minus TA, operating temperature. So QD is C into A into, sorry, TO minus TA by 2. Okay, we have used this equation so many times. This is not the new equation. So QD or heat dissipated equal to C is what? Heat dissipation coefficient, that is given as a 600 into area is L into D, 75 into 50, but it is in mm. So for 75, 10 raised to minus 3, and for 50, 10 raised to minus 3 becomes 10 raised to minus 6. So now C, then A into TO minus TA, that is 60 minus 15.5 by 2. So QD will be 50.06. What? Watt. So in this way we have calculated heat generated as well as heat dissipated. In previous cases we have considered that heat generated and heat dissipated are same. It is not possible actually. Getting? You can see here the difference 5818 watt and 50.06 watt. So there is a big loss. Okay. But in theoretical cases we can consider that generated and dissipated heat is same. Okay. So as per the requirement of numerical, we have to assume certain things. Okay, so we are stopping here. I am declaring that our syllabus is completely over with the 4 units. Okay, thank you.